Hello, once again. Welcome to Drafting Lifestyle. This is your coach for today, Coach Gene, and welcome to our channel. Last video, we talked about the setting up of units, OSNAP, and options. Those are one of the most important setup na kailangan natin sa pag-setup ng ating AutoCAD. Today's video, we'll be talking more about layers. We are going to set up our layers. Ano ba ang function ng layers? In the most simplest definition, layers is responsible for creating different line types, line thickness, and as well as assigning colors while we are working on our AutoCAD. Yan ang trabaho ng isang layer. Also, in this video, we are going also to set up our dimensions. Para pagkatapos ng video na to, we are going to have our first drawing output in our AutoCAD drawing. Okay? So are you ready? So let's get started. As you can see, this is our entire workspace in our AutoCAD. We have here the different commands under the menu bar with different functions. But this time, I want you to focus first on the middle. Itong layer command, itong layer bar area. As we can see here in the middle, we only have one active layer. So kailangan gumawa tayo ng apat na layers for our first drawing, especially sa mga beginners. Sa mga beginners kasi importante ang pag-set up ng apat na layers na ito. Okay, so here we go. How to set up our layer is simply by pressing LA in our keyboard. Hit enter. And then, lalabas na ang ating dialog box ng layer. As you can see, you have here we only have here one layer available. So, how are we going to create the layer? Looking at this area, here, it says here, new layer. Open and close parentheses, Alt plus N. That is the shortcut in creating layer. So, first, you have to click on this area to start with a new layer. After clicking, may lalabas dito na sinasabing Layer 1. So sa Layer 1, dito natin papalitan ang mga names and layers that we need to change. So what is the first layer that usually do? In our drafting class, we usually have these four layers. We have the borderline, the object line, the fine line, and the text. Ano-ano to siya sa paggawa ng unang drawing namin? So, let's have the first one, borderline. So I'm going to change the word borderline here and then just press enter. Kapag meron na tayong borderline, we have to choose what color that we usually do. In our class, ang usually na ginagamit namin is green. Okay? You can choose your color that you want or what type of color that you like based sa inyong preference. Pero sa akin, kasi usually na ginagamit ko naman talaga to ever since nagsimula ako mag-AutoCAD, green na ang pinipili ko. So once I am done choosing the green color, I'm gonna hit OK. After which, you have to change here the default line. Sa continuous line type, hindi natin siya papalitan kasi straight line lang ang kailangan natin or solid line. So, continuous lang ang kailangan natin dito. But for our line type, usually, in our drafting class, ever since that we have our class under sa drafting namin, usually, the line weight that we have for borderline is 1 millimeter. Standard practice na kasi namin to dati pa. So, 1 millimeter borderline thickness is usually that we are having in our class. So, once you press 1 millimeter and then hit OK. So we already have our first layer. Next, I'm going to create layer for fine line. Ang fine lines, ginagamit namin to sa mga line weights, sa mga line types or mga object na kailangan ng hindi masyado kailangan ng expression. Okay? So we exist, the line exists but it does not really capture. So in other words, these are just medium fine lines, okay? So fine line and then hit enter. Now, choose the color that you like. For me, I like the color that is hindi naman masyadong matingkad based sa preference ko. So, I'll just have a click blue, something like this, para hindi naman masyadong masakit sa mata. So, depende pa rin sa atin kung anong gusto natin. But for our line weight, we only need to choose 0.20 or 0.25 millimeter thickness. So that's, for me, that's already enough. Pero kung gusto niyong gawin mga 0.25 or 0.30, kayo na rin bahala. Pero in our setup, we usually have this 0.20 and then click OK. Then we also need layer for object line. These are lines that are second na thick line compared sa borderline. So object line, these are lines na ginagamit natin for visible areas and edges. So in the alphabet of lines, object line is being explained as a solid line, a heavy thick line that shows the surface of an object. So for us, we usually have line thickness of 0.30 or 0.35. So kayo na bahala if you choose 0.30 or 0.35 depending on kind of preference that you have. For me, 0.35, that is okay. So click OK if you are already satisfied with the line thickness. And then lastly, we have here the layer for text. So text, type text here and then click enter. So to check here, change the color, we are going to have the text as if yellow color. Pwede. So text. So okay na to siya. So para sa akin, okay na to. And then for the line thickness, I'm going to have here at least 0.15 or 0.13 depende sa preference or sa gusto ninyong thickness sa kanya. So click OK. Now, we also forgot here to change the color of the object line. Usually, sa preference namin, we use cyan as an object line. Parang principle na kasi namin to na ginagamit ang cyan. Pero sa inyo, depende kung ano ang representation ninyo sa mga kulay. So click OK. So we already have our 4 layers that we usually do for our first drawing output, especially sa mga beginners. Okay? So once tapos na tayo, just press or look, point your mouse on the left corner, lalabas yung mini icon na X dyan to close. Minsan, meron dito sa right, pero kadalasan sa actually change is the arrowheads. So, maraming klaseng arrowheads that you can choose here. But in our setup, in our own preference, we usually have origin indicator. Sa origin indicator, as you can see, dito sa left side, dito pinapakita kung ano ang mga changes na ginagawa mo sa inyong dimension setup. So, to check here, the arrowhead head size, usually, ang choose namin dito is from 0.22 to 0.25. Kayo nang bahala if you want bigger. So, if you have here 0.25, it is already a little bit bigger size. That is standard for 1:100. Okay? The rest, leave it as it is. Now, on the second tab, you are going to choose text. Okay? On the text tab, I'm going to choose only is the text height. The first thing that I'm going to change here is the text height. Commonly, ang text height na ginagamit namin is only 0.15 in height. Hindi naman siya gano'ng kalaki, hindi naman siya gano'ng kaliit. Also, you are going to make some changes here sa text placement. Sa text placement, ang ginagawa namin is outside. Choose outside so that makikita natin lahat ng dimensions natin nasa labas ng dimensions. And for the horizontal, I'm going to change here as centered. On the text alignment on the other side, I'm going to choose align with dimension. You could also choose ISO standard. You could also choose align with dimension. Either of the two, you can use. Okay? So, for me, I'm going to choose align with dimension. Okay. And then, after you set it up here on the text tab, proceed to primary units. Dito natin papalitan ang precision. It is very important for us to change. Decimal figures. The rest of the setup must be lived as it is. Soon, when we are going to have our topic on scale, kailangan na natin itong palitan to have another